worship is so that the doors of our hearts may be open so that we can receive from Him. Amen. Isn't that why we come to church? So that we can replenish. Amen.
Amen.
No matter what culture we come from or what our week looks like, we come here to praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And we are brothers and sisters. Amen.
Amen.
So let's worship God together. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. You know, that song is so important for us to do in this season because it's very easy to get bogged down with culture and work and relationships that we lose sight. Sometimes you just keep going and you forget how far you've come without praying or how far you've gone without really reconnecting. And what comes with that when we distance ourselves for so long? Guilt, right?
Yes.
Can everybody agree with that? What's partnered when you feel distant? The first thing you feel is guilt, right?
Yeah.
And we talk a lot about the difference between guilt and conviction, right? Conviction is the Holy Spirit reminding us to come back, and guilt is what the enemy uses so that we don't come back. And that's why it's so important to listen to the Holy Spirit. We are children of grace.
Yes, yes.
And that's what it is. God said it, and so it is. You know where your hope is built on, right? Come on, church.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' love and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame.
Oh. His face.
Yes.
I rest on His unchanging grace.
you so many times. We fall short so many times. We fall on our knees so many times. Search our hearts, Lord. Search us and make us better, Father God. Fill us where the world has left a void. Where people have hurt us. Where circumstances have calloused our hearts. Break those walls, Father God. Break those chains. So that we can receive you. Thank you, Father. We know you live in each and every one of us. We know you reside in our spirit. No matter where we go, no matter how dark things look, Lord, you are with us. You are with us.
Sweet the sound that saved our
Father, prepare our hearts for this service. Prepare our hearts for what your word has. Thank you that you are faithful and that you are true. Even in our weaknesses, Lord, you are our strength, Father God. You are where we turn when there's nowhere else to turn, Father God. Lord, teach us to be more like you, to embody your characteristics, to honor you when it is most difficult, Father God. Have your way today. Why don't you just greet your brothers and sisters, amen?
Jay, please, would you mind if I share just very little? Living Word, I just want to publicly just share what God has done for me. When it's time for praise and prayer request, I've been so used to I can't say that, or what would this person think, what would that person think? And so this week, especially the 19th, and then also this morning, everything that we've been singing about has been when we started to sing this morning, and also when it was time to sing Cornerstone, I just felt like I wanted to burst and just speak up and say, this is what God has been doing for me. This is what God has been doing for me. In the devotional this week and also this morning, it spoke about how He knows everything about you already, which we hear all the time. But this time it talks about how, you can relax in my presence. You can just start telling me what's on your mind. And I was able to begin to do that. And I've been able to just begin to just talk to God and know that I don't have to watch myself. I don't have to be self-conscious. And this is what God has done for me, because many, 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 many years coming up here, being afraid, having the wrong fear of God. This morning I was able to tell God, God, thank you for setting me free.
Hallelujah!
Because now He's helping me understand that I don't have to try to. He knows everything. All the little somersaults that I try to do, He knows it, and I can just leave that alone. Thank you, Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name.
Yes.